All right, let's get right into this. It's been a while since I did a Let's Play, but I'm going to do one live here on twitch.tv/LELELEX2. We're playing Deadly Premonition Origins. Now, I've played Deadly Premonition 2 to completion. But I haven't played Origins. Actually, Deadly Premonition 2 is my first game in the series. Alright. Strange clock is ticking away, though the room itself makes you feel as if time has stopped. True, a little freakish. A doll shaped like a fat man has a plate on it which reads Washington State. A dummy for hanging costumes gives me the creep somehow, though it might be used for jackets and such. Alright, I got a trading card with my fucking face on it. Let's take a look. It's me. White screen.
Sorry to keep you waiting. It will start soon.
Interesting.
It's about time to get started.
Like I said, the textures on this game are crazy. Not crazy good, but just, you know, they look crazy. Like, Deadly Premonition 2 is already, like, not that great of a looking of a game, and this one's kind of like, eh.
Zach.
But it's okay. It's not about how it looks, but the quality of the content, right, guys?
York.
It's like what MLK said.
If you can hear my voice, could you respond? Good. I thought you went to sleep. Zach, don't be surprised. The crime took place out in the country this time. Let's take it slow. Okay, Zach?
Sure, that's one way of looking at it, but it's totally wrong.
Okay, base. Dude, you know, I'm familiar with Francis York Morgan.
Listen, they both need each other. It's called interdependency.
Oh my fucking god.
Yeah, I know. He does terrible things to Tom. Nasty, even sadistic things. But that's fine, as long as that's what Tom wants. Think of it. His actions. He's always asking for it. It's his partner's job to fulfill that need, and Jerry knows that.
Yo, GZ, buddy, GZ.
Proof? Well, in the Tom and Jerry show, they live with each other.
Let's talk about fucking Tom and Jerry.
Hello?
Back. I can't believe the Bureau still can't get me a satellite phone.
These puppies are making me go to another town in the boondocks again.
Well, I'll be a happy camper, even if it ends up being a waste of time. At the very least, it'll get me out of the cramped city for a while. Right, Zach? The perpetrator from the last case really was something. Who'd have thought there'd be razors laced into your nails? Crazy. Just crazy. At least I now have a scar to show off. See this? I got this when I arrested the Catwoman wannabe. Women, they're crazy. Don't you agree, Zach?
God damn it, bro. I was looking at the goddamn substitute. I was looking at my job, bro. I was looking at my job. Like, the job's getting away of the fucking grinds. I missed the jump scare. Let me turn off the light real quick. What the fuck is under me? What the fucking guy, bro? Alright. Hey, you know, it's not how I start off most of my episodes, but it's chill. Okay, we'll be alright. I look like a Game Boy SP. Zach, this is Deadly Premonition. It's like Twin Peaks, if you ever seen that. Alright, well, I don't really need the flashlight. It's pretty fucking bright out here. Okay, I got a pipe. Holy smokes, this option screen is way different than the second one. The second one has like no soul compared to this one. What the hell? Wait, I have a sleep and a hunger meter in this one as well. Interesting. Not the noise I would use for entering a, you know, for entering a menu, but. I see. Yeah. I'm getting flashbanged. All right, let's start profiling.
Looks like we're being welcomed. Zach, I'll let you handle the meet and greet.
I don't remember that from the first game. Or from the second game. The lighting looks ages old. True. That's true. My God. All of a sudden, huh? The hell is walking like that? Rude, actually. It is demons, actually. Good guess, buddy. Good guess. I played the second game, so that, you know, the villain of the first game is already spoiled for me, but... We're playing through the first one for the fans. This is normally what I do, follow women into shacks. Like, no cap, see a woman enter a shack, I'm there. Okay. Got a can of pickles. Okay. Power grid. Let's turn it on. Simple enough. This is Liam's type, no cap. My god, I just pulled my gun out. Where's my steel pipe at? I'm trying to conserve ammo right now. Oh, it's gonna force him, dude. Just let her have it, man. Just let her have it. You got mysterious shadow. It's happening so fast, like, whoa. Draw it, aim with R. Okay. Draw up and lock on with ZR. What is that meter in the upper left? My heartbeat? Why is the music so intense? Oh, still more guys. Wait, they just deadass did the, that's what Akuma does. Oh, you have unlimited ammo? Was there unlimited ammo in the other one? I feel safer. You know, I just feel safer, guys. You know, I just feel safer. GRNVAL. Looks like we're headed down this road, Zach. True. Zach, what's the word, bird? Oh. Quick time event. I definitely do not remember this. I think you know why I don't remember this thing. In number two, you go to like a dream, when you sleep, your dreams hold all your FBI investigation things.
Takes the cake. It's the first time I've been attacked so directly. Zach, can you give me a logical explanation about what that was? Never mind. Don't answer. Life is fun because of the mysteries, right, Zach?
Right, Zach? Okay, so I save at telephone poles. Okay, where did you save before? I wonder if you could save anywhere in the other one. But we'll find out, buddy. We'll find out. Oh yeah, this just looks like a clue. Better eat it. Trust me, if food was on the fucking clue on the evidence list, you'd never find it in a locker after I got to it. I honestly just don't remember. Okay, which one's to pull out my gun? Like, get your gun out and shoot this rat.
Great.
Okay. So now I know those are explosive. Alright, let me see if we can't change the controls. Okay, look, draw weapon. Hold breath, lock on. Attack. Like, is there no way I could change, like, yeah, why? Be a better button. Could I change this for attack? Oh, it even changes the other ones for me. Like, that is so helpful, actually. Yes. Oh, wait, hold on. I just saw another option I wanted. Autosave. Hell yeah. Just autosave up, buddy. Okay, so now, if I'm aiming my gun... Alright, yeah, this is way better. Oh, it even changes on the UI. This is a good game. Like, developers of fucking today could learn a thing or two.
That was awkward. Alright, so now we got some more steel pipe, but I don't know why I would ever use steel pipe. I have... Oh my god. The guy's dead-ass moaning in my ear. That was kind of scary. That was a tad scary, buddy. I'll say it. That was a little scary. Didn't want to die. I'm just lucky that I'm finding these generators. Alright, whip out the tool. Whip out the piece, buddy. Oh, that was easy.
Amazing.
I might be going pro in this game at this rate. I'm kind of owning. Can I break everything? Oh, perfect. That takes ages. Okay, there's gotta be a faster way to equip, unequip weapons, right? Like, if I just press every button. There's gotta be a faster way than this, guys. Alright, well, so far there's not a faster way, so... That was worth it. Alright, yeah, that's a pretty good weapon. Oh, I have a durability, I see. I got stabilizer. That's awesome. Okay, did I go in a complete circle? Hello? No, I have not gone in a circle. But somebody has severely damaged the generator here. Generator looks really bad, Zach. I think the killer really had a grudge against it. Yeah. I'm getting clued in right now. Let's start profiling. Turned into a real fucking grand old time. Now that, you know, that just feels good, you know? That just feels good. Now this, I fear, I don't want to get blown up. I'm just not feeling that right now. Did I die on any of the bosses in Deadly Premonition 2? Can't remember. I want in my heart, I want to say no, but I know that it can't be true. Wait, I can smoke? I need bandages. But I do have smokes. Let's see, can I hit this barrel? Oh yeah, I'm the best. Any loot? What the? No loot. Now, if this is a good game, I'll be able to shoot this off the lock. Oh, hell yeah, okay. This actually just might be one of the best games ever made. Sorry to tell you. Like, I know you probably worked on Concord or something, you know. Overwatch 2, you probably think you worked really hard on that shit. You're not even close to this. Like, boom, right between the eyes, buddy. Frances York does not miss. When she's done dying, I'm gonna get in here. What the? Holy, what the? I have the fuse box. Perfect. I'm just like running through my head right now. I'm trying to figure out the power in the area should be much more stable to her, Zach. I'm trying to remember if there's a lot of these little puzzles in Deadly Premonition 2. Deadly Premonition 2, you go to like the Shadow Realm a lot and you do a lot of shit in there, but I don't remember anything like that. I actually do not remember a single puzzle. I remember trying to find beans for the pastor though. That was something. Alright. Something else has just got to change, sorry. No. Is there no way to change? I guess there's not. I just have to live with it. I just have to live with the pains. Alright, that's fine. I can get over this. Oh my god. Is this like BioShock where I get a good ending if I don't kill all the little girls? Oh. You make a Deadly Premonition 3. Just let him have it, man. Like, just let him have it. Like, hell yeah.
Amazing.
That was a good game. Now, what is this? This is like fog? Oh my god. Chill with all that. I'm out here handing them out right now. You do not want to get one. Let's see. Ah, he actually got to me? What is with the noise every time I... Oh my god. Hey, talk about a beamer, buddy. Put me on the CSGO team. I'm lasering kids right now. What I wanted to say is, what's with the piano chord every single time I shoot a barrel? Is that really necessary? Oh, there he is, bro. Oh my god, let's go! My reactions are insane. Some might say it's fake. Okay. Well, I'm gonna ignore that for now. I'm actually gonna go in the opposite direction.
Amazing.
Or is this where I came from? Damn. They got my ass. They pranked me.
Great.
Oh! You hear that fucking glass shatter? That means beamer! Okay. So my psychic detective powers are letting me know that that is a terrible choice. Car crashes get you way more age and honor.
Amazing.
What a beamer, dude. I might, if there was a ranked competitive of this game, I'd already be so good at it. I'm just destroying right now. Who else thought that tree was going to be a waypoint? Just like a beam of light. I should observe so we can get some more flavor text. My bad. This is what it feels like to get a phone call from Liam. All right, the Red Ivy. Okay. Getting visions of the past and the future.
There's definitely something in this town. Do you feel it, Zach? Coffee warned me about it. Yesterday morning, the milk I poured in my coffee made a sign. It said, "Tomorrow you'll arrive at a place that will change your fate."
Alright, buddy, we'll do a subathon till I hit legend. No need to sub, though. I provide that kind of content for free. Oh, hell yeah! Now this is a video game. There's no fucking way they want me to run all the way there. I don't even dare travel this direction, actually. Like, look how far I could go. Like, you think there's actually something back there? I'm already 100 yards away. I'll just run, like, a little bit farther. No, hell no. This has got to be one of the best video games ever made. I'm not even joking. When was the last time a video game just let you... Wait a minute. Fuck to everybody but me. Get pranked. Everyone thought that was pointless. Wrong. Just made $50. Wait, there's another one. Okay, so I have a... Oh, no. I have a fucking heartbeat meter. Do I deadass have to... Okay, what if I fill this up, do I take a break? Oh my dude, what is this? GTA San Andreas? Oh man, this is whack. I'm an FBI agent. How far is 700 yards? Get shit up. 700 yards and miles.
700 yards is 0.4.
It's not even a mile. It's not even a half a mile. It's 0.4 miles. The FBI agent can't run half a mile? I just don't fucking believe it. That's probably why the Bureau didn't give me a satellite cell phone. What the? I'm 200 yards out. I didn't even get to finish my run.
Now you were very late. I didn't think you'd keep me waiting in the rain for so long.
FBI Special Agent.
Hell yeah, whip his badge out. Shut up, lady. Just
call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Agent York?
Good, that's good.
Are you the sheriff?
No, I'm Deputy Sheriff Emily Wyatt. George, he's the sheriff. He went looking for you, actually. He should be back soon.
I see.
If you don't mind me asking, did you walk all the way here?
My car broke down, that's all. She's easy on the eyes. Definitely worth a trip to the primitive world. By the way, don't mention anything about what happened back there. She'll think you're a psycho. Don't want that, do we, Zach?
Welcome to Greenville. I'm the sheriff.
Oh, where the hell did this guy come from?
Call me George. FBI Special Agent Francis York Morgan. Please, just call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Could you tell me why the FBI is so interested in a small-town homicide?
Let's just say it's a personal interest in killers of young women. I'm always looking for new sample cases to help me with my profiling.
Both our superiors have cleared this with each other. You can remain in command. You don't have a problem with this, do you?
No. No problem. Just want to set things straight. Our small town has its share of problems. I'm the one fixing them one by one and maintaining peace and order. You can have your profiling sample, but I need you to understand that.
Of course.
Just blows smoke in their face while he's trying to talk. That's something my brother would do.
Oh, and my clothes and luggage are still inside.
All right, don't worry. I'll get my assistant Thomas to take care of it. Do you need anything else?
Thanks. That'll be all. Well then, I think I'll rest up first at the hotel.
Why the hell are my eyes black?
You on your investigation.
Don't know how to say that. We really don't need your help. Unlike some of your corrupt city police officers, I play it by the book. I hope you'll come to appreciate that, Agent Morgan. And we'll handle the investigation. You just think of this as a vacation. Take it easy. Enjoy the nature here. You don't have to be a tree worshiper to appreciate the wildlife here.
Zach, let's reassess the situation. There are no cavemen here. We're as far forward as the Middle Ages. And we've just met the king.
Based. I love mom, also Baze. What console did this game release on first? It wasn't the Switch, was it? Basic wage, unpaid salary? Okay. If it's unpaid, how did I just get it? Okay, if I get that 12-gauge shotgun, that would be awesome.
Previously during the investigation.
Okay, this is the Zack view.
Another town in the boondocks again.
I didn't think you'd keep me waiting in the rain for so long.
Welcome.
Something in this town. Do you feel it, Zach? My coffin warned me about it.
Oh, okay, yeah. See, now this reminds me a little more of Deadly Premonition 2. Angel Isaac. Okay. I think the demon in this game loves donuts. I think that's his main thing. Donuts are a clue. Hey, who knocked my TV over? No option to return it. Door wasn't locked. Yeah, me and the demon have a lot in common, buddy. And my mannequins are flipped around. Oh, okay.
York. Don't breathe. Hold your breath. They can't see you if you hold your breath. Hurry. Like this. Cover your mouth.
Oops. All I had to do is hold the trigger button. All right, let's give that another shot. You know, first time's a charm. All right, good luck on Nomer, buddy. I hope you wipe and lose your hardcore. Wait, sorry, you're not playing hardcore, are you?
York.
Never mind, don't wipe. Okay, this time I'm not gonna choke.
Don't breathe. Hold your breath. They can't see you if you hold your breath. Hurry. Like this. Cover your mouth.
Who are you?
That's definitely me as a child. Me and that guy got the same freckle in the same spot on our face. But I don't know why I would call myself York, though. Yeah, exactly. I got the same freckle, right side of the face, upper right side, bottom left side. Like, call me the fucking detective, buddy, alright? I solved the Smiling Man case.
Zach, the symbolism in my dreams continues to intensify. A forest of red trees. A carpet with red leaves. A strange doll. And twin angels.
But that child is what bothers me the most. I swear I've seen him before. I just can't remember where. Well, it'll probably come back to me eventually. For now, we need coffee.
Let's head to the cafeteria, Zach. I hope they have some real coffee. I really need some coffee. Then we can head to the sheriff's office. There's a proper procedure for everything, right, Zach?
Okay, so coffee, then the sheriff's office. Like the door wasn't locked. All right, thanks, man. Well, I can't tell if I'm shaved or not, but I think I actually do look a little more cut. Now, this is an elaborate bathroom. A door to get into the bathroom, a door for the shitter in the bathroom. Like, what, why wouldn't that one door there have a lock if, you know, you're gonna do this combo fucking shitter thing? Just my thoughts, you know, as an architectural genius. Alright, more long hallways. Save early, save often. $35 for a cracker. No. I thought I was pressing B. You're tweaking. I just bought a $35 cracker. What is the difference, and why is one $31? Or do you buy the milk one? Do you buy the black one to avoid omens in the milk? Ah, it's the classic Deadly Premonition song.
Mr. Morgan, your breakfast is ready for you.
Thank you, Mrs.
Polly Oxford. Just Polly is fine.
Well then. Thank you, Polly. I'm starving.
Is everything all right, Mr. Morgan?
Why is the table so long?
Yes. It's delicious, Polly. My compliments to the chef.
I'm hoping my cooking will bring back repeat guests. Honestly, though, it's been a while since anyone has stayed here.
I couldn't help but notice. Aside from you and me, there seems to be no other guests or workers around.
What's that? The salt's in that white shaker there.
Thank you. I was wondering if there were any other guests or workers here.
Oh, no. No one else. My husband and I used to run this place, but he's in heaven now.
You've been working here alone since then. Must be hard by yourself.
Oh, my. We're all out of pepper. I'm very sorry.
It must be difficult to run a hotel by yourself.
Well, yes, I suppose. I could just live on my pension. But I have to admit, running a hotel is kind of like a hobby of mine.
That's nice. Polly, it might help to hear you better if you could sit a little closer.
Oh my, Mr. Morgan, you're embarrassing me. So early in the day, too. I think I'm a little too old for you.
And I still love my departed husband. May God rest his soul. I appreciate the invitation, but I'm fine over here.
Polly... I can hardly hear you from all the way over there.
You're exaggerating. This is fine. It won't do to be all clumped together with such a large table and cafeteria. We have to make use of all this space. Now tell me, that wound on your face, what happened?
Let's just say I had some trouble during the last case I was working on. I'm sure it'll heal. It's just a flesh wound.
Oh, my. Well, there's no need to be the tough guy here. I want you to be able to relax here. I've prepared a special room for you. A famous rock star once stayed in the same room, you know.
Really? I feel honored.
If you need anything, anything at all, just let me know. I'll help you out in any way I can.
Zach, the lady is offering to help. Do you want to ask her about the town?
Say, yeah.
Polly,
what can you tell me about this town?
Well, let me see. You might know this already, but the town is called Greenvale. It rains here quite often, but it's a nice place, surrounded with nature. It was a big and prospering lumber town.
What? This game's a fucking riot.
That's why this place is so big for such a small community.
I have so many fond memories from that. I suppose the clock on the community center is quite famous too.
Clock?
Oh yes, it's lovely. It rings in the morning and at night to let the whole town know the time. You'll hear it many times during your stay. It's a beautiful sound. And you'll love it too, I think.
I look forward to hearing it then.
Anything else you'd like to know about?
Yeah.
Yes, actually, Polly. Could you tell me about the shops around here?
Shops? Well, there aren't many. It is a small town, after all. You can do most of your shopping at the Milk Barn convenience store. The couple who run it are a unique pair. I'm sure you'll get to like them. The A&G Diner is a great place to eat. They might be open even if my kitchen is closed. If you want to go to a bar, there are two. The Galaxy of Terror and the Sweary 65. I don't care much for either of them. Bars are for the younger folk. We also have a gas stand, of course, the art gallery, and even a gunsmith. You should be able to find what you need.
Thank you, Polly.
Well, Mr. Morgan, I better start cleaning up. You just take it easy. I'll bring your coffee out in a moment.
Thank you, Polly. I have to warn you, though. I am very particular about my coffee. The very best you have, please.
I understand. I'll be right back with it.
Uh-oh. This is where we get another omen.
Did you see that, Zach? Clear as a crisp spring morning. F.K. in the coffee. I knew I could count on it. Never fails.
Now then, let's get going.
Interesting, interesting. Well, I can just get coffee. Oh, there was a fortune telling in there. Okay, so the coffee can help direct me in the game. I don't think that was in the second one. Little tidbit. Little bit of info. Wait a minute. Point of view here. Clear day. I wonder if that weather reflects the weather in game. What? Okay, well, I don't know. The sound effects on this are not necessary. Ooh, well, what can I buy? Donut, bait. I could go fishing in this game? Yeah, I think that was in CQ101's fishing video, no cap. I think the video we watched of his, he reviewed the fishing in this. Okay, yeah, this is a good game. I could items that I can't fit in my inventory, instantly I can send to my stash. Like, bro. when did this game come out? Like, you know, it's just so far ahead of its time, man. You know, it's just far ahead of its time. Like, it was speaking, but were the people listening? And this has got to be one of the best songs ever composed for a video game. It's just so good, man.
A police car.
I honestly listen to the song so much and I never get tired of hearing it. 9 to 5. Don't be late, Mr. Woodman.
So we have King George to thank for preparing a car for me. A pleasant surprise, eh, Zach? Let's take it for a spin. I have to tell you, Zach, this place simply amazes me. The keys were left on the front hood, and nobody stole the car. Values. This town has what the country needs. Values. Let's head over to the sheriff's department.
Why are there so many controls? Wipers, signal, headlights, accelerate, side brake, boost, brake, reverse, honk, steer. Am I actually going to need it? I don't even think I'm going to use a single one of those. I'm just going to drive the car like it's GTA. Bro. There's just no way. Okay, so that's how you leave the car.
Zach, is there something here that you want to check out?
We're supposed to go through Anna Graham's file at the sheriff's office, but if you want to act on a hunch, then I'm with you.
What button was accelerate? Oh, okay. Am I stupid? I'm legit pressing every button. Okay. Was there an ignition button I was missing? You know, I got every other button on here. I guess I wasn't respecting it. Okay. So there's no controls. I could have sworn... Ah, here we go. Okay, we'll drive like this. I think this is developer. This is how the developer intended me to drive. There's gas and durability. God damn it. So, Zach, about those bonus features in DVDs nowadays. You know, the ones from the 80s almost have no bonus material. Even if they do, it's a trailer. The visual quality is pretty bad. Well, the visual quality is a good reminder of those days. So many new audiovisual appliances were coming out back then. Oh shit, I missed my turn, man. Can't read and drive. Just dinged my fender. Is there a reason why there's no sound besides the music? That's you. Hey, remember Attack of the Killer Tomatoes? Filmed in 1978. Produced, directed, written, and edited by John DeBello. It was really awful, but for some reason, I still remember it pretty well. It had so many sequels, and the original was re-released in 95. 87-minute long theatrical release bumped up to a whopping 90 minutes, but that was around the time I joined the Bureau. I never have a chance to see it. I know, Zach. Once this case is over, we can watch it together. I bet we can buy a copy on the internet pretty easily. Shit, I'm making a left, guys. I'm making a left. Ah, there's a trading card. Put the brakes on. No way, it's locked. Am I crazy? Where'd my sound go? Hello? I just wanted to pause the game to see if they could, you know. Well, everything's working, according to this. Wait a minute. Okay. Wait, the same button that's accelerate is the same button to quit. Anyone else find that? Buddy. Okay, so you can't let go of the gas? Okay, it's a little vicious, I think. Let's see if I can't just, like, fucking whip it in here. Alright, perfect. Alright. Go. Okay, yes, and there's no brakes. I just feel like that's cheating. I feel like this is in the spirit of the, you know, does the boost button do anything? I'm like perma 40 miles an hour. I knew it. I knew you were gonna try some shit like that. I just knew it, man. I was like, oh yeah, it's all fun and games, bro. What does this sound like? It sounds like Jimmy Neutron, buddy. All the kids in America. Why is there no other sound? What button did I use a second ago to let me turn my head around? Ooh, yeah, I'm a speedrunner. I just whipped that shit around. Oh, dude, no. Okay, how do I get out of this pickle? I guess we just have to fucking drive backwards now. Because I can't press R again. I let go of the gas because I fucking tipped my shit. Dude, please. No way. I'm not gonna make it, dude. Oh, this is so lame. I failed. Oh, that is lame, dude. Okay, and boost, I learned, just does this. I'll be back for that racing minigame. This is a good song too. It's one fine building for such a small town. Your woodwork is spectacular, don't you agree, Zach? Okay, obviously I'm experiencing some kind of auditory glitch. Like, fuck me. Damn it, dude, I'm missing the dialogue. Just call me York. Why did this glitch happen to me, man? Okay, I'm going to skip this. I'm going to press start. Somehow, I've just lost the ability to listen to shit.